We've teamed up with Vitality with their ambassador, the one and only, my former teammate, Maro Toji. Let's get inside. He's waiting. He's waiting for me. Can you believe it? I don't know who the star of the show is, but it's, yeah, I've kept you waiting. How are you?
I'm well. How you doing? Long time no see.
So a little bit away from rugby, I want to talk about Maro Toji, the style icon.
That's an old photo.
Yeah, it's an old one. We've got a few newer ones. We've got a few fresher ones. There we go. There we go. The roll neck. Who?
You know me. I love my roll necks. Yeah. I love my roll.
It's normally the white one. How important is a stylish Maro Toji?
The thing is, you know, the clothes I wear is not for everyone. That's the good thing about style is that everyone has their unique twist to it. So like what I think is cool, you may not think is cool, but as long as you're comfortable in the clothes that you wear, then I think it's all good.
I think we've seen an evolution of yourself away from the rugby field, and you've shown that to people as well. Can you explain what that is to me?
Yeah, African art. I can't draw, but I have a strong appreciation of it. The texture, the colour, the how vibrant it was. I like African art in particular because it feels, I don't know, I get a sense of connection to it, and if I feel it really like speaks to my soul, so yeah, I love it.
And how important are your Nigerian roots?
Yeah, it's massive. It's my Nigerian roots is a key part of who I am. It's a key part of how I was raised. It's a key part of how I see the world. My parents, you know, they raised us in North London, but our household was very much Nigerian. So it was a massive part of who I am.
So some influential figures.
Yeah, JJ Okocha, big Super Eagles fan, and he was the man. He was our David Beckham, basically. He was incredibly skillful, incredibly talented. You got the sense that when he was in your team, like, you couldn't lose. You know, I don't think I've met a Nigerian who doesn't love JJ. So yeah, JJ's the man. I wish I was good at him at football. Yeah, Muhammad Ali, the greatest. The reason why I find this man so inspirational was that not only was he a great boxer, he had a purpose beyond the ring, and he was able to connect in ways that not many athletes could. Especially in his time, he was talking about like black empowerment, being proud of being black, and like especially given the context in which he was operating, it was one, like an incredibly courageous thing to say, and two, you know, he just was a great example for so many. President and First Lady Barack and Michelle Obama. So obviously the first African-American couple in the White House. So even just from a symbolic point of view, I think is incredibly powerful. You know, that picture, that the sentiment behind those two achieving what they've done, like reaching the highest office in the land, I think is incredible. And as with all politicians, you can debate their policy, you can debate what they've done and what they actually achieved. But for me, I think both of them are two inspirational characters.
More importantly, you've tagged them on social media. Have they followed you back?
I don't know if I tagged them. I've definitely posted them.
Sia Khaleesi, we'll start with him.
Yeah, Sia's great. Sia's obviously made history with his role at the Springboks. I've spoken to him, spent a little bit of time with him. Incredibly nice, warm, welcoming human being, and you know, I think his success kind of speaks for itself.
And his mate?
Evan, again, another quality operator. He's second row like myself. Both of them are the talented individuals. Both of them are great rugby players. They both achieved a lot in the game. So yeah, you have nothing but respect for both of them.
So last question then, it brings me on to the tour. How are you feeling about going down there with the Lions and playing South Africa?
No, I'm incredibly excited. And to be honest, it's not too different from The last tour, we were going down to New Zealand. New Zealand were the world champions at that point in time as well. And you know, these are the type of challenges, these are the type of tours, these are the type of opportunities as a player that you want to be a part of. So on an individual level, I'm incredibly excited and pumped to go down, to be honest. I'm very happy that the tour's going ahead, and you know, I'll do whatever my role is to ensure that, you know, we have a successful tour.
Class, Maro. That was brilliant. And for me personally, it was great to be a small part of that journey and watching you grow and hearing about you talk about these influential figures, from you as a young boy to your family to kind of where you are now, and wish you well for the future, and I'm sure we'll see you shoot for the stars.
Thank you very much, Jim. Thank you.